So I'd like to mention about some slides from ASLD 2017. This is the latest at the presentation of the NFALD and ASLD. They have some prevalence and epidemiological study. They mentioned about that meta-analysis of 34 studies and NFALD prevalence, severity, and prognosis regarding about 368,000 patients. And what they found is NFALD prevalence is about 11.2%, and NFALD risk is very high in Hispanic compared to the white patients. The related risk is 1.36%, and then black versus white patients 0.68. So definitely the black is less incidence of NFALD than the white patients. And the NASH prevalence is only 31.4%. And then the Hispanic versus white patients 1.24, and the black versus white patient is 0.72. So definitely the Hispanics and the white patients, they have more the incidence of the NFALD. And they found that F3 and F4 fibrosis in the prevalence of the NFALD is 19.5%. And then F3, F4 fibrosis NFALD patient, the white versus Hispanic 1.02 and white versus black 1.01. It's definitely the white patients have more fibrosis than the black and NFALD patients. And definitely association between fibrosis severity and clinical outcomes. If you have a very severe fibrosis, like a bridging fibrosis, and child score 5 or CTB score 6, that is the incidence of the outcome, severe outcome is more worse than the more advanced fibrosis. And association between the fibrosis severity and the clinical outcomes, definitely first occurrence of the hepatic decomposition is 26, F3 fibrosis about 16%, cirrhosis is 28% in CTB score A5, and cirrhosis is 52% in CTB score A6. Then hepatic decomposition is more worse in the advanced fibrosis, 52 out of 44 patients. And definitely major cardiovascular events, we have 26 out of 9 in F3 fibrosis, and then CTB score A5, 4 out of 63, but we cannot find out very severe cardiovascular event and CTB score A6. The non-hepatic malignancy, like Professor Wen mentioned about the breast cancer and colorectal cancer, it's occurred in 10 out of 26 patients in F3 fibrosis and 10 out of 63 patients in CTB score A5 and 0% in CTB score A6. So the consequences of the NFALD is not only liver-related complication like fibrosis, cirrhosis, liver cancer, they have some cardiovascular events and they have non-liver-related malignancies. So this is very important for us. We consider about a lot of NFALD patients, and then we are treating NFALD patients. We look for the non-liver-related mortality, cardiovascular events, as well as the non-liver-related malignancies. So cardiovascular risks in patients with NFALD, they have a retrospective studies of 6 related accidents, and they found that cardiovascular deaths in general population in 33% lower in women versus women. However, NFALD population is not different in between the women and men. That means NFALD may attenuate the sex-based cardiovascular disease risk advantage for the woman. So definitely, if you have a NFALD, the incidence of the cardiovascular disease is more or less the same, because the woman, the estrogen cannot protect the incidence of the cardiovascular disease in the woman. So any cardiovascular events is 0.94% in NFALD, which is compared to the 0.77% in control. So that definitely evidence of high cardiovascular disease in NFALD patients. Thank you very much. This is end of my presentation.
CFAM, caring for well-being.